Hello people, I'm Dr. Ashray Khanna, founder and CEO of Inspiring Mindz. So as you all know that the MBE has already declared the date for the FMGE of this session, which is 31st of August. So now I'm getting messages and mails from many of the students that, sir, we are still very much confused and we are feeling as to we cannot do anything for now. And very few days are left, time is very less and we don't know what to do and how to do. So if you just check the I button on top, you can check the strategy for last 3 months and for the last 1 month. And you can make your own strategy according to the mix and match technique, and you can make your own schedule and strategy what you feel is right for you, because there is no set strategy which works for everyone. So what we have been telling you is what has worked for us. So now talking about any strategy for say last 50 days or so. So but still we have sort of made the test series again, as we are already conducting the test series from past 1 month for those who are already writing the FMG in the coming August. At that time dates were not yet released, but now as the dates are released, many more students want to join in the test series. So let me be very clear about it. This test series for this year is completely free of cost and you don't have to pay anything. But the good part with our test series is that it is not any traditional or conventional test series. What we actually do is we ask you to study in these segments so that you don't just go after any one particular subject and study it for the whole day and the efficiency decreases by the afternoon or the evening and still you just keep on sitting with your notes. So that is not gonna help you at this point of time considering the number of days. So what I'm gonna tell you is study according to the segments, and the segments you can see here as well. So according to these segments only we are going to conduct the test. Okay, so for example the segment A is derma, anesthesia, psychiatry and medicine. And yes, we are conducting this segment's test on 12th of July. Okay, and the physio, patho, pharma and the medicine, the remaining part of the medicine from segment A, segment B, we are going to conduct this test on 19th of July. Okay, and the FMT, ENT, ophtha, small subjects, you're gonna get 5 days for this and it would be on 24th of July. Anatomy, surgery, ortho and radio, you have again around 7 days for this and it would be on 1st of August. Then biochem, pedia, OBGY would be on 7th of August. Last, micro and PSM would be on 13th of August. So this is how you can actually finish all the subjects in the span of 35 days. So now I told you we have around 50 days. So 35 days we have used for our test series and we have more or less revised all the subjects in a better format, and you have already tested your recalls and how much you have already prepared before in the form of the test, and you would be having these scores in front of you. Now after we are done with it, we'll start with the revision. So talking about the revision, I just want to mention one thing here is don't wait to finish all the subjects and then start with your revision. No need to do like that. What you have to do is daily for at least 2 hours. 2 hours daily you have to revise whatever you have read the previous day. Okay, so don't just leave anything for the last 15-20 days to revise. Keep on revising everything side by side. Now the revision according to us, as I already told you, it has to be done daily. Along with that, the segment A, B, C, mock test of segment A, B, C would be on 16th of August, and the mock test of remaining segments D, E, F would be on 19th of August. So this way, two mock tests and complete segments would be revised again. And now after that, we would be having 4 more mock tests, which are from 21st till 27th. So how you have to do that? For example, 21st, you would be giving your first complete mock test. Then on 22nd, you have to analyze, or let's say on 21st only, you have to analyze whatever you have did wrong and whatever questions you knew but still you were unable to mark the right option. So which means you still have to revise those particular topics in which you are still not able to get the correct answer in the first go. so that the next day, let's say 22nd, you will get the time to revise all those topics again and then reappear for the mock on 23rd. Same way, the consecutive day would be free, and then after a gap of one day, you'd be having the another mock. So that is how we'll have four complete mock tests, two mini mock tests of our segments, and six tests for the segments, in which we'll incorporate all the subjects and all the highest yield topics. So what I want to tell you is, no need to worry about anything at this point of time. The one thing which matters is, if you think you're gonna pass, you will pass for sure. But if you have the minutest of the thought in your mind that you might not pass, then I can guarantee you that you won't pass at all, in spite of you just sit for these 50 days. Okay, so what difference you can make right now is, just clear all the negativity inside your mind. No need to listen anyone, no need to even talk to yourself about this. The only thing which matters for you is, you have to pass and you will pass. Okay, apart from that, shut off all these thoughts and start with your revision, start with your studies. The more you prepare, the more marks you will get. As simple as that. Nothing else, nothing else at all. You have 50 days, it's enough. Just keep on working hard. Whenever you have any doubt, whenever you feel low, you have my number in the description down below. Join us on Telegram to get all the good questions, high-yield questions daily there as well. And you can join us on Instagram as well. I am coaching, and you will get many more questions there, the clinical questions there. And for this test series, you can just download our application and you'll get the batch code as well. Just start on with your preparation. No need to waste any more time. Switch off the YouTube. It is not going to help you anymore. As simple as that. And yeah, daily you have to solve MCQs for at least 1.5 to 2 hours. Like daily you have to solve a minimum of 100 to 150 MCQs daily. And the time, according to me, should be somewhere around 9:30 till 11:30 a.m. And for our test series as well, the time is going to remain the same. So yes, don't forget to solve the MCQs, because that is what really going to help you in the exam as well. Good luck, and we hope and we wish that you all clear your exam with the highest of the marks. Okay, thank you so much, guys.